let me just, since a lot of people are probably near this, in just a few sentences. What we're saying is that the pioneers, the settlers, the colonists who came to the New World, who came anywhere, just stumbled upon free masonry, literally. And they're called the Freemasons because they're kind of cheats, they're kind of liars, they're kind of nefarious characters, as we know very well now. But they just took these buildings that were just already there. They were already built. They were built by a previous civilization. They were built by, most likely, the Antediluvian people. And that's Antediluvian, A-N-T-E, ante as in before, diluvian as in deluge, as in flood. So there's your etymology as well. And so they just show up, and these buildings were basically, it's like petrified into stone because it was under tremendous pressure, under miles of water during the Great Flood, made famous by Noah's Ark, which was a real thing that happened. And the ship was big, like a cruise ship, not even as big as a cruise ship, a modern day cruise ship, but it didn't have to be because it was still able to fit all the animal kinds on it. And who said they were full grown adults, huh? There. And, you know, you just need a couple wolves, a couple, cats, and you get all the other varieties out of that. So there you go. Maybe they can't breed today, but at one point they could. They descended from the same cat kind or canine kind or whatever kind. So when the Tower of Babel happened, this is my, now it's getting into like me and Wise Up, and I haven't heard too many other people just go off on this. In this direction, but there have been a lot of directions, and I don't discount the credulity of the other directions. It's just that because of my personal experience and beliefs and insights, wisdom, or lack thereof, whichever way it turns out to be, however you may view it, I believe that the people were together at the Tower of Babel. They got broken up, divided because of the confusion of languages, where each family got their own language, and they spread out across the earth, and they found these buildings in place. They just had to dig them out of some silt and soot and, or not soot, but silt and mostly mud. Mud is what you see in all the oldest paintings and all the oldest photographs, and the oldest photographs are probably older than you realize. And all those old paintings and old photographs, what do you see? You see a bunch of mud, and they dig it out, and there are these beautiful buildings built for people much taller than today. And so what do you have to do? You have to dig it out? Well, you just kind of sandblast it off, and see, this looks old. This doesn't look like brand new masonry. And then you have to put on a new roof. And that's what you see happening here. They're putting on a new roof. And if you zoom in, it looks like the new roof is going on over kind of an older roof. This looks like steel. I mean, that looks like an afterthought. That is not the same construction style or materials or anything as this. And then what you see as stone may not have been stone, like these banisters.